A local search and rescue group is asking for your help after their dog was shot. Good evening and thanks for staying with us at 5:30. I'm Doug Proffitt.
And I'm Renee Murphy. River City Bloodhounds are trained to help track down people in need, but now they're asking for your help to find the scent after someone shot one of their dogs. WHAS 11's Holden Kerwicki spoke to the dog's handlers today and joins us now with more on this story and how this all may have happened. Holden?
Well, Doug and Renee, these dogs are kept in a fenced-in backyard in a neighborhood full of dog lovers. But after a .22 caliber bullet was found in the belly of one of the bloodhounds, their owners can't believe it wasn't an accident, and they believe that this was foul play. For the last 3 years, Michelle Mantilla and her husband have lived in this quiet Georgetown subdivision with their four-legged friends.
They're just a big, drooly, slobbery mess of love. You don't own a bloodhound, they own you. I mean, they're big babies. They are lovable dogs. They're gentle giant, you know? So it's my heart.
However, her heart was broken when her husband went outside to feed their dogs a Sunday morning special, pancakes.
And Maisie's normally the very first dog when there's food involved, you know, to run at you, and she didn't. So we brought her in and checked her over. And we kind of thought she was bloating because bloodhounds are prone to bloat.
After rushing Maisie to Shively Animal Hospital, the doctors discovered an issue much bigger than bloating.
They put the x-ray up and was like, somebody shot your dog. Immediately I felt like just scared and uncertain because I had three other dogs at home. And I was just like, you know, why would somebody do this?
The Mantillas were home at the time but never heard a gunshot. And that has turned her dream home into a house of horrors, even after she called the police.
There's no sense of security. It just was taken away pretty quick. If somebody would be that bold, you know, to come up that close to the yard and shoot a dog, what would keep them from shooting somebody else's dog or a child? Or just like, who are we really dealing with and what kind of person are we dealing with?
Michelle Mantilla tells me that Maisie has started to eat again and should be able to come home later today. Her handlers hope that she is able to make a full recovery and continue her career as a search and rescue dog by this fall. Doug, Renee?